Search and rescue teams continue to comb the waters of South Korea today. They're looking for survivors from that sunken ferry. 26 ships, along with sailors from the ship and salvage unit and underwater demolition teams, are taking part. At least 9 people are confirmed dead so far, with about 300 people still missing. Most of them are high school students who are on a school trip. Their parents are gathering at the staging site waiting for word. Our Heather Sells has the latest.
Parents anxiously wait as search and rescue teams continue to comb the waters off South Korea. But strong currents, rain, and bad visibility are making it hard for rescuers to search the vessel and nearby waters. Parents are clinging to hope with text messages like this from one missing 18-year-old. "Dad, don't worry. I've got a life vest on and we're huddled together." Another son simply texted, "Mom, I might not be able to tell you in person. I love you." This family received the devastating news their son did not survive. The ferry was carrying 475 people, most of them high school students, on a school trip to the tourist island of Jeju. But after traveling overnight and with just 3 hours left to go, the ship began to list. One crew member now says an immediate evacuation order was not issued, and that could have cost lives. Instead, the ship's officers spent a precious half hour trying to stabilize the ferry before telling passengers to get off. The captain of the ship, seen here hiding his face in his sweater, has apologized.
"I am really sorry and deeply ashamed. I don't know what to say."
First responders were able to reach the ship using helicopters. Rescuers lifted some passengers from the deck, while others clutched onto railings until they could make it onto rescue boats. "It was very intense," says this man. "The ship tilted more than 45 degrees. The ferry sank in the 90-foot seas in just 2 hours. So far, no word on what caused the tragedy. Heather Sells, CBN News.